Hey guys, Jake here with 8020 Media, bringing you another common problem video. Today we're going to be discussing the 5.0 Cummins, but more specifically the 5.0 Cummins that was used in the Nissan Titan XD. The 5.0 Cummins is a little bit different from the larger 5.9 liter and 6.7 liter Cummins engines that are used by Dodge in the sense that this is a 90 degree V8 rather than a traditional inline six. Nissan added this to their Titan XD in 2016 when at the time Ford, Dodge, and GM were all coming out with their various kind of smaller diesel engines that were being used in their half-ton pickups, like the 3.0 Eco Diesel, the 3.0 Power Stroke, and the 3.0 Duramax. So Nissan said, hey, why not put a diesel engine in the Nissan Titan? However, rather than engineering and designing their own engine from the ground up, they reached out to Cummins and opted to use the 5.0 Cummins platform, which was a pre-existing production engine being manufactured already at the point by Cummins, which made it an easier engineering fit to be able to work it into their Titan XD lineup. Now, it was launched in 2016, however, sales of it were very low. The engine does have a number of problems, not uncommon with these smaller diesel engines like we've discussed with some of the 3.0 liter ones, but also it was a nearly $10,000 add-on above the V8 gas engine, and it only offered 1,000 pounds more of towing capacity. So overall, it just really didn't have great sales since it didn't offer a whole lot more than the gas engine and was very expensive, not to mention some of these reliability issues that we're going to cover here. So jumping into common problems, the first problem on our list is with the DEF pump. The DEF pump takes the DEF fluid from the tank and takes it to the SCR system. The pump commonly fails, which requires the tank to be dropped and the pump to be replaced. The pump costs about $1,000 and labor is going to run you $500+. And so it's a relatively, expensive repair to have done, especially considering how common of a problem it is. In addition to the pump, other issues with the DEF system are excess DEF consumption, as well as false regen cycles. So overall, there have been a number of issues with the DEF system in the 5.0 Cummins in the Titan XD. The second one is with the EGR valve and the EGR cooler. The EGR valve frequently gets gunked up over time from carbon deposits, which can cause it to either get stuck closed or stuck open. When this happens, it'll cause a number of performance-related issues and the valve will need to be replaced. Additionally, the EGR cooler is prone to cracking. This was covered mostly in a recall. However, there are a number of vehicles that were not a part of the recall that still are having issues with the EGR cooler. EGR valves are pretty, there's two of them. Each one of them's $500+. The EGR cooler is about $1,000, and it's not the easiest system to service. And so EGR related issues with this engine are expensive to repair as well. The third problem to discuss is with the transmission. So not necessarily related to the 5.0 Cummins, but Nissan opted to use the ASIN 6-speed transmission, which was very poorly calibrated and not well put together from a designer engineering standpoint. And this has led to a lot of issues with it, with overall drivability issues and lack of a smooth transmission. So you get a lot of hard shifting. The transmission frequently overheats. We get a lot of jerking, gear slipping. And so overall, the transmission has been a rather problematic and overall kind of uncomfortable transmission to drive around in. There have been a number of complete transmission failures. However, that's not necessarily as common. There have been a number of transmission recalibrations, but the majority of these recalibrations have not addressed or fixed a lot of these issues with the hard shifting and jerking. The transmission remains to be a common problem point in these vehicles. The fourth common problem is turbocharger failure. The 5.0 Cummins uses a whole set M2 twin sequential turbo, and it is known to fail due to poor lubrication that's caused by low oil pressure. There was a recall on about 12,000 XDs to fix this issue. However, it has remained to be an issue in some of the non-recalled vehicles as well. Essentially, what happens is low oil pressure causes oil starvation within the turbocharger, which can cause the turbine wheel to contact the turbine housing. And if that happens, it can send metal shavings all throughout your engine and require a complete engine replacement or rebuild. As mentioned, there's a recall on 12,000 of these vehicles. Depending on the severity of the failure, depends on whether you get a new turbocharger or you get a completely new engine. But with that being said, this is a pretty significant problem, and it has been a problem for non-recalled vehicles. So the recall was for 2016 vehicles, which is the first year of the engine, but there have been a lot of 2017 and later models that have experienced this problem as well that have not been covered under recall. So while it mostly affected the 2016 models, 2017 plus is not in the clear from turbocharger failure issues on these engines. The fifth problem is with the CP4.2 injection pump. This was most common on 2016 models as well, but again, also something that's been seen a number of times on 2017 and later models, but essentially the fuel pump fails and the fuel level sensor are also known to fail as well. Fuel pumps are relatively expensive, and so this is another expensive repair or expensive problem with the Titan XD. So that covers it for our common problems. While it wasn't the most exhaustive list, the majority of the problems on this engine are with major engine components like the EGR system, the DEF system, the turbocharger, and the fueling system. And so ultimately, this is, in our opinion, not the most reliable engine out there. And typically when it does have problems, the problems are relatively expensive to fix. There have been a number of great Titan XDs out there, but with that being said, we would probably avoid this engine, one, due to the cost to purchase it, and then repair costs with it as well. Another kind of caveat to that is Nissan doesn't offer any other diesel engines in their lineup, and so when they discontinued this engine, they went ahead and fired all of their diesel mechanics, and so there is no longer any support from Nissan for these engines, and so if you need repair work, you can't go to the dealership for it. You'll need to look to independent repair shops. If you are looking at a Titan XD with the 5.0 in it, we would recommend definitely avoiding 2016 models. The 2017 plus models do tend to be a little bit more reliable, but they are still prone to some of the problems with the 2016s, like turbo failure and fuel pump failure, just not quite as frequently as with the 2016 models. With regards to the major engine components themselves, like the block and the internals, those are all strong and durable. Basically, any system or component that was produced by Cummins tends to be pretty reliable and durable, but it's a lot of the kind of additional engine systems that were engineered by Nissan that have problems. So overall, the 5.0 Cummins itself is a great engine. However, the combination of the 5.0 Cummins inside the Titan XD makes for a rather unreliable combination. And so this gets below average reliability marks in our book. Thanks for watching, guys. If you appreciated this content, we would like it if you gave the video a like and subscribe to the channel to stay tuned for future videos. Now, we might be talking about trucks. This might be a Nissan, but it does have a turbocharger in it. So if you like turbocharged vehicles, stay tuned for when we put this Precision Turbo 6266 into our N54 as we do a single turbo swap on it, which will be coming in future videos as we do a build series with the 135 that's right here behind me.